إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالًا كثيرًا ونساءً، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يدع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed, the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance we have is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وكل محدثة بدعة. And everything we newly invent into this deen of ours is an innovation. وكل بدعة ضلالة. And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وَقُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ. Every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثُمَّ أَمَّا بَعْدْ. عَمْ صُهَيْبِ أنه سمع من أبي هريرة ومن أبي سعيد يقولان خطبنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يوما فقال والذي نفسي بيده ثلاث مرات ثم أكب فأكب كل رجل منا يبكي لا ندري على ماذا حلف، ثم رفع رأسه في وجهه البشرى فكانت أحب إلينا من حمر النعم. ثم قال ما من عبد يصلي الصلوات الخمس ويصوم رمضان ويخرج الزكاة ويجتنب الكبائر السبع إلا فتحت له أبواب الجنة فقيل له أدخل بسلام. This hadith, which is Hassan in the Sunan of Al-Nisa'i, Abu Huraira and Abu Sa'id, they heard the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, or they said, he was addressing us one day and he said, by the one in whose hand is my soul. And he said it three times. And then he lowered his head, and each of the companions lowered their head, and they began to weep and to cry, because they didn't know what he was swearing an oath by. And then the Prophet ﷺ, he lifted his face, and upon his face was a face of joy and happiness. And that was dearer to us, they said, than the red camel, to see this relief and joy on the face of the Prophet ﷺ. So then the Prophet ﷺ, he said, whoever, there is no one who offers the five daily prayers, fasts Ramadan, pays their zakat, and stays away from the seven major sins, but the gates of paradise will be opened for him, and it will be said to him, enter in peace. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بني الإسلام على خمس شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة وصوم رمضان وحج البيت. Prophet Muhammad muttafaqun alayhi. In Bukhari and Muslim, we see the narration that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that Islam is built upon five. The shahada, the bearing testimony that there is no God worthy of worship except for Allah alone without partners in truth. And that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and servant. And to establish the salah five times the day in the day. To pay the zakat on your wealth, to fast Ramadan, and to make hajj once in your lifetime if you're capable of doing so. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, He says, حافظوا على الصلوات والصلاة الوسطى وقوموا لله قانتين. Allah says, safeguard, guard strictly the five daily prayers. especially the middle prayer, the prayer Salat al-Asr, and stand before Allah with obedience and humility. This Iqam al-Salah is not just that you do the prayer, because Allah, He mentioned the one who performs the prayer versus the one who establishes the prayer. لما قال فَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ. So wail, according to Shaykh Abdullah al-Bukhari, he quoted Qadi Iyad, rahimahullah, saying that wail is a sense of potentially a valley in the hellfire. Or it's one who's fallen into destruction and grief. One who's found difficulty in punishment. So when wail is mentioned, this is what it could be referring to. It's all bad in the first place. So woe to be to those who establish, woe be to those who perform the prayer. They are those who delay their prayers past their fixed times. So Iqam al-Salah is not just that you perform the prayer, but that you do it as Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhumah, he said, that Iqam al-Salah is to perform ruku'iha, it's ruku', wa sujoodiha, it's sajda, وَقَرَاءَتِهَا, and its recitation, that you do these completely and perfectly. And you fear Allah and have attention to what you are saying. This is Iqam al-Salah, this is the establishment of prayer. So the one who doesn't do it in its time, or the one who doesn't do the ruku' and the sujood properly, then you must ask, have I been the one who establishes the prayer, or am I just doing the performance? Am I just doing the action? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he saw a man pray, and he told him, "Irja' fasalli fa innaka lam tusalli," go back and pray because you did not pray. And the man did this 3 times, so he said, "I've done what I know. Teach me how to do it correct." And this is where we understand to follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with regards to our prayer. كَمَا قَالَ صَلُّوا كَمَا رَأَيْتُمُونِ أُصَلِّي. Pray as you have seen me praying. And this should be the matter of our prayers. And some perform the salah, but they will not get the first full reward, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in the authentic hadith, authenticated by Shaykh al-Albani in the Sunan of Abi Dawud, he said, قال رسول الله إن الرجل لينصرف ما كتب له إلا عشر صلاته أو تسعها ثمنها سبعها سدسها خمسها ربعها ثلثها نصفها. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, a man may complete his prayer, and all that he gets of reward is 1/10, or 1/9, or 1/8, 1/7, 1/6, 1/5, 1/4, 1/3, or half. So the salah isn't just that you perform it, and you come and you stand, and you bow, and you prostrate, and you don't do them in the correct manner, and you don't do them at the right time, or you have no attention in it. Establishing the prayer is that you have full attention to those things. Ikhwani akhwati fillah, the Prophet ﷺ was in Mecca after the first revelation of Iqra. He called to Tawheed for 10 years only. There was no Salah, no Siyam, no Ramadan, no Zakat, no Hajj, just calling to Tawheed for 10 years. So this is the first thing that is upon us to do to the people, call to the oneness of Allah, that He's the only one worthy of worship. After 10 years, He was given the gift of Isra and Mi'raj. He and this ummah were given the gift of salah. Because salah is a gift. Because it pulls us from this dunya and it reminds us of where we should be. And what we should be thinking. And where our mind and our feet and our soul should be grounded. This salah is a gift. So it came on that mi'raj. So this is the importance of the actions. After tawheed, salah was the only thing. For 3 years, then came zakat and Ramadan and hajj and all the other legislations. Just to show you the grandeur of Tawheed and the grandeur of the Salah. It was narrated from Anas ibn Malik that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, فَرَضَ اللَّهُ عَلَى أُمَّتِي 50 صَلَاةً فَرَجَعْتُ بِذَلِكَ حَتَّى آتِيَ عَلَى مُوسَى عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ فَقَالَ مُوسَى مَاذَا فَرَضَ رَبُّكَ عَلَى أُمَّتِكَ قُلْتُ فَرَضَ عَلَيَّ 50 صَلَاةً قَالَ فَارْجَعْ إِلَى رَبِّكَ فَإِنَّ أُمَّتَكَ لَا تُطِيقُ ذَلِكَ. The Prophet ﷺ, he said that Allah enjoined on this ummah 50 prayers in a day. If you had to do 50 prayers, every 16 and a half minutes, you have to do a salah. Who would be able to do it? This is what he enjoined on this ummah though. And he said, I came back down through the heavens and I came to Musa. He said, السلام, what did Allah command your people to do? He said to pray 50 prayers in the day. He said, irja' ila rabbik, go back to your Lord. إن أمتك لا تطيق ذلك. Your ummah will not be able to do this. So he went back to Allah in different narrations saying it came down by 10 or it was cut in half and this and that until it got down to 5. فَرَجَعْتُ رَبِّي فَقَالَ هِيَ خَمْسٌ وَهِيَ خَمْسُونَ لَا يُبَدَّلُ قَوْلُ لَدَيَّ فَرَجَعْتُ إِلَى مُوسَى فَقَالَ ارجع إِلَى رَبِّكَ فَقُلْتُ قَدْ أَسْتَحْيَيْتُ مِنْ رَبِّي. So it got down to 5 prayers. When he went to his Lord, he said, there are 5, but you will be rewarded 50. And he said, my word, it does not change. So I went back, and Musa alayhi salam again, he said, go back to your Lord. Your people aren't going to do the 5 in the day. And he said, I feel shy before my Lord, so he didn't return. In one narration, we see that Musa alayhi salam, he said, فَإِنَّهُ فَرَضَ عَلَىٰ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ صَلَاتَيْنِ فَمَا قَامُوا بِهِمَا فرجعت إلى ربي عز وجل فسألته لتخفيف فقال إني يوم خلقت السماوات والأرض فرضت عليك وعلى أمتك 50 صلاة فخمس بخمسين فقم بهذا أنت وأمتك فعرفت أنها من الله تبارك وتعالى. In one narration in the Sunan of Nasa'i, which is graded as Hassan, one related that Musa alayhi salam, he said, my ummah, Bani Israel, the children of Ya'qub, they were commanded for only 2 prayers in the day, and they couldn't do it. And this is why he kept saying, go back to Allah, your people won't be able to do this. So I went back to my Lord and I asked him to reduce it. In one narration, he said, the day I created the heavens and the earth, I enjoined 5 prayers upon you and your ummah, 5 for 50 reward. So establish them, you and your ummah. And I knew that this was what Allah Azza wa Jal had determined. So I went back to Musa alayhi salam. He told me to go back again, but I already knew what Allah had determined. So I did not return to him to ask him for more. Rahmah from Allah, mercy. But that salah still in and of itself is a gift for us, as we're going to continue to see. Allah, he told us, the salah is the means for you to be forgiven, to earn Allah's mercy, to earn Jannah, to have happiness and success in this life and the next. Allah, he said, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Successful indeed are the believers. May Allah make us from them. He listed their sifat, their characteristics. The first of them, الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. Those who in their prayers, they pray with submissiveness, khushu', humility, humbling themselves before their Lord, begging for guidance, for mercy, for forgiveness, and to be admitted into paradise and saved from the hellfire. وقال الله وأنا اخترتك فاستمع لما يوحى إنني أنا الله لا إله إلا أنا فاعبدني وأقم الصلاة لذكري. Allah Azza wa Jal, he said to Musa alayhi salam, and I have chosen you, so listen to what I'm inspiring to you. Verily I'm Allah, and there is none worthy of worship except for me, alone without partners. So offer the prayers, so worship me, and offer prayer perfectly for my remembrance. لذكري. When we need help, when we need aid, when we need support, when we're feeling hopeless, when we're feeling down, depressed, anxious, sad, it is the salah that will elevate you from these conditions. It is the salah that will bring you closer to your Lord. It is the prayer that will make you successful in this life and in the next. For Allah's remembrance, because He told us in the remembrance of Allah, تطمئن القلوب will the hearts truly and indeed find rest. وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أول ما يحاسب به العبد يوم القيامة من عمله الصلاة فإن صلحت فقد أفلح وأنجح وإن فسدت فقد خاب وخسر. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, for the believers, the first thing they will be asked about on the day of resurrection will be their prayers. If it is sound, then they will be prosperous and they will have succeeded. But if it is bad and corrupt, then they will have failed and lost. They will have failed and lost. So it's not good for one to just say, La ilaha illallah, but not pray, not give zakat, do all the sins they want to do. You're putting yourself in harm's way. Because the first of the actions you'll be questioned from, after you passing the test of Tawheed, will be, did you establish your prayers? And if they're sound and good, prosperous, you'll be prosperous, you will have succeeded on that day. In reality, if the prayers perform truly, and you remember Allah, and you repent to Allah, and you seek forgiveness from Allah, this will have the lasting effect on the individual. Never cut your prayer off. The prayer, هذه الصلة بينك وبين ربك. It is the connection between you and your Lord. For you to go and talk to Him, confess to Him, pray to Him, beg of Him, plead to Him when you need help and when you need aid and when you need guidance and when you need mercy. It is the salah. Even if you're upon every major sin, never cut off the salah. You cut the salah if you cut off Allah. So you never cut that prayer off. إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر. It is the salah that will help you avoid great sins and immorality and evil deeds. So even if you're sinning, don't let shaitan convince you, you're filthy, man, you're dirty, don't go and pray. How, you're such a hypocrite going to pray and you're doing these sins. بالعكس, the exact opposite. You are the one who needs to come and pray with the Muslims and pray with your brothers in Islam in the masajid. Why? So that Allah can remove that veil from you, remove that sin from you, and help you through your prayer get rid of that sin and immorality. So if the prayer is done right, this should make us more righteous and bring us closer to Allah Azza wa Jal. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خمس صلوات افترضهن الله تعالى من أحسن وضوءهن وصلاهن لوقتهن وأتم ركوعهن وخشوعهن كان له على الله عهد أن يغفر له ومن لم يفعل فليس له على الله عهد إن شاء غفر له وإن شاء عذبه. This hadith, which we find in the Sunan of Abu Dawood and Nisa'i, and Shaykh Al-Albani, he graded it as sahih. The Prophet ﷺ said, Allah has obligated five prayers upon you. Whoever excellently performs their wudu, according to the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, and makes ruku' and sujood, according to the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, and prays them in their times, and has khushu', has a promise from Allah that He will forgive him. He has a promise from Allah, the one who perfects his wudu, makes his salah as the Prophet ﷺ made it, and you try your hardest to focus in your prayers, then you have a promise from Allah that He will forgive you. And whoever does not do so, then he does not have that promise. Allah may forgive him, or Allah may punish him. So these prayers are a purification for us. Five times a day, to meet our Lord, to praise our Lord, to beg Him for guidance and forgiveness, to repent and feel remorse for our sins. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أرأيتم لو أن نهرا بباب أحدكم يغتسل فيه كل يوم خمسا ما تقول ذلك يبقي من درنه قالوا لا يبقي من درنه شيئا قال فذلك مثل الصلوات الخمس يحمى الله به الخطايا. This hadith, which we find in Bukhari and Muslim, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, if a person had a stream outside his door and he took a bath in it five times a day, would he have any dirt on him? The companions, they said, he wouldn't have no dirt on him. If you took a bath five times a day, you'd be the cleanest of people. He said, this is the similitude of the five daily prayers. Allah wipes away the sins by them. قال رسول الله الصلوات الخمس والجمعة إلى الجمعة كفارة لما بينهما لما بينهن. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, between the five daily prayers and from Jum'ah to Jum'ah, Allah will expiate the sins, the minor sins, what is between them, the major sins we need to make tawbah for and we need to repent for. So here the scholars, they stress the compulsory standing that we should be praying and establishing the prayers five times in a day at the minimum to purify ourselves of sins and to get closer to our Lord. And this was the command for even our youth, for our children. When Allah, He commanded the parents in the Sunnah of Abi Dawood, in a hadith which Shaykh Al-Albani, he graded as Hassan, مروا أولادكم بالصلاة وهم أبناء سبع سنين واضربوهن عليها وهم أبناء عشر سنين. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, teach your children the prayer from when they're 7 years old. 7 Hijri years, mind you. 7 years in the Muslim calendar. And spank them lightly and reprimand them when they're 10 if they're not doing it. Why? So by the time they hit puberty, they're going to be the people who establish the prayers in their times and don't miss them. So you're protecting your children by following this sunnah, teaching them the salah so they know what to say in ruku' and sujood, the tashahud, the fatiha, and the likes of these matters, so that they're in the role of doing it by 10, so that when they hit puberty, they're from those who establish the prayer. May Allah make us of those who establish the prayers. Brothers, if you can move forward, barakallahu feekum. And there's some prayer in the parking lot if there's overflow. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وبعد. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, there is a hukum for tarik as-salah. There is a ruling for the one who has left the prayer, who doesn't pray. Whether they're Muslim or whether they're disbelievers. And of these groups, there are those who, they're broken into the ones who are not disbelievers. These are the ones who pray regularly. They may have slept through a prayer, forgotten a prayer. But as soon as they remember it, they pray it right away. Right? This person doesn't fall into a kafir, into disbeliever. Then there's the group that are automatically kuffar, the disbelievers. They deny the salah. They deny that it has to be prayed. They reject its obligation. Out of pride, out of envy. They recognize Islam as the truth, but they say, I don't need to pray. It's not something that I have to do. They do not submit to it. So one who doesn't pray out of disdain or out of rejection or ridicule for the prayer, one who refuses to pray even when they're told to and told about the threats of not praying, then this person falls into being a kafir, a disbeliever. But then there's that middle group. And there's a difference of opinion whether they're a Muslim or they're out of Islam. Those who accept the obligation to pray, they don't deny that it's important. They do not deny that they have to do it, but they just don't do it. They know they're sinning out of laziness, such that they don't perform the prayer. Some of the scholars took the view that this person is out of Islam and not a Muslim and in Jahannam forever. And some took the position, because of the hadith we mentioned earlier, that Allah may forgive him or he may punish him, they took the position that he's an evil doer, committing a lesser kufr at the doorstep of being a disbeliever, but not necessarily into disbelief. The scholars who took this position, that he's not a disbeliever, they say you warn him, if he still rejects starting to pray, then he falls into being a disbeliever. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بين الرجل وبين الشرك والكفر ترك الصلاة رواه مسلم. Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, he said, between a man and between being a mushrik, a polytheist, and a kafir, a disbeliever, is his abandoning the prayer and not praying the prayers. ثم قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أنا أهد الذي بيننا وبينهم الصلاة فمن تركها فقد كفر. And in this hadith where it's mentioned in the Sunan of Abu Dawood, Tirmidhi, and Nisa'i, Ibn Majah, and it is greater than Sahih, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, the covenant between the believers and the non-believers is the salah. The covenant between us and them is the prayer. Whoever abandons the prayer and does not pray, faqad kafar. He has committed kufr. He has committed disbelief. When we look at these two narrations of the Prophet ﷺ, we see why the majority of the ulama consider the one who does not pray a disbeliever. So there's still time if you're living to start establishing your prayers. Never cut those off. But listen to what you fall under if you abandon the prayer and you fall into disbelief. And this is from the works of Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen, rahimahullah. He mentioned that Allah says in the Quran, وَإِن تَابَ وَإِقَامَ الصَّلَاةِ وَإِتَاءَ الزَّكَاةِ فَإِخْوَانَكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ. Allah Azza wa Jalla, he said in the Quran, what means for the mushrikeen, if they repent from their shirk, and they accept Tawheed, and they don't do any shirk, and they establish the prayers, and they pay the zakat, then they are your brothers in deen. Then they are your brothers in faith. So what was the shurut? What was those conditions? They repent from shirk, so they're upon Tawheed. They establish the prayer, and they pay the zakat. Then you become a brother to your other brothers in Islam. More proof that this position is what is the heavier weighted one, that the one who does not pray is not a believer. عن عبد الله بن شقيق رضي الله عنه قال قال كان أصحاب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا يرون شيئا من الأعمال تركه كفر غير الصلاة. عبد الله بن شقيق, he said, the companions, the Sahaba, they did not come to a consensus that leaving any action is disbelief. Like they did though with Salah. They were under consensus that the one who abandons the prayer commits disbelief, commits kufr. He's in a state of being a disbeliever. All the other actions prescribed to us, they had differences of opinions whether he was a sinner or out of Islam. But the Salah, they were in consensus with respect to it. وَإِذَا تَبَيَّنَ أَنَّ تَارِكَ الصَّلَاةِ كَافِرٌ فَإِنَّهُ يَتَرَتَّبْ عَلَيْهِ أَحْكَامَ الْمُرْتَدْ وَلَيْسَ فِي النُّصُوصِ أَنَّ تَارِكَ الصَّلَاةِ مُؤْمِنْ أَوْ أَنَّهُ يَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةِ أَوْ يَنْجُو مِنَ النَّارِ. And if it's clear that a person has left the prayer and it makes him a disbeliever, then he reaches the level of a murtad, one who rejected, apostated from Islam. And there's nothing in the text or the narration that say that someone who doesn't pray is a believer, or that he'll go to Jannah, or that he'll be saved from the hellfire. So now, because of the timing, just some of his narrations, or some of what the Shaykh mentioned with proof, all of these have proof in the ayat. We won't mention them because of the timing. But to get the point across, he said it's not correct for a non-praying man to marry a Muslim woman. He may say the shahada. If he does not pray, do not marry him to your daughters. And if he did so, النكاح باطل. The nikah is void. It does not count. It's null. And if you have a non-praying woman, she should not marry your sons. This is a must that the both of them establish the prayers. And if one of them leaves the prayer after his nikah, then his nikah, ينفسخ, it is cut off, it is annulled. If you were praying when you were together, the husband and the wife, and then one of them stops praying, of course, at first you will advise them, hey, you need to do your prayers, wake them up, encourage them, tell someone to talk to them from the family or the friends. But if they don't do so, then their marriage is annulled. Ya ikhwani wa khawati fillah, these are grave warnings, proof, adilla, in the Quran and the Sunnah. Proofs and evidences in the Quran and the Sunnah. إذا هذا الرجل الذي لا يصلي إذا ذبح لا تأكل ذبيحته لماذا؟ لأنها حرام ولو ذبح يهودي أو نصراني فذبيحته يحل لنا أن نأكلها فيكون والعياذ بالله ذبيحته ذبيحه أخبث من ذبح اليهود والنصارى. And if he is someone who does not pray but he goes to slaughter an animal for eating like a sheep or a goat or a cow, then his slaughtering is not accepted. This meat is not halal for you to eat. Even if he's someone who says the shahada, even if he says Bismillah Allahu Akbar, if he is not someone who prays, that meat is not halal for you. You know what is though? He says the meat of the Yahud and the Nasara, the meat of the Jews and the Christians. Because Allah, he said, وَطَعَمُ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابِ حِلٌّ لَكُمْ. Because in Surah Al-Ma'idah, Allah said, the meat of the Christians and the Jews is halal for you. But this meat that someone who says they're a Muslim but does not pray slaughters is not halal for you. It is worse than the meat of the Christians and the Jews. It's not permissible to enter Mecca or its boundaries if you're one who does not establish the prayers. If your relatives die, they cannot inherit from you if one is a disbeliever. كما قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا يرث المسلم الكافر والكافر المسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the authentic hadith that a Muslim cannot inherit money from a kafir, and a kafir cannot inherit money from a Muslim. وقال, and he said, وأنه إذا مات, and if he dies, لا يغسل ولا يكفن ولا يصلي عليه ولا يدفن مع المسلمين. If he dies, you do not wash him, you do not shroud him, you do not pray the janazah over him, and he cannot be buried in the cemetery with the Muslims. Imagine having to do that for a loved one, but we're too shy and we're too, you know, relaxed that don't want to advise them to salah. We don't want to bring them to pray. But then you get to this point and you want to be able to even bury them with the Muslims. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, this issue is very grave and it's very important. This is without a doubt a conclusion of the majority, Jumhur al-Ulama, the majority of the scholars. It's the same in and of itself. Even the ones who said he's not a disbeliever, once you advise them and tell them if they reject it, they fall into kufr. They fall into disbelief, so do not belittle the matter of salah, the first action from the actions that you'll be asked about Yawm al-Qiyamah. So abandoning the salah is an extremely heinous crime. And no true Muslim to Islam should ever consider abandoning the prayer. And if you do, if you see your friend, your brother, your sister, your mother, your father, your daughter, your son, anybody that you care about and love, you call them to the salah, you remind them with text, with phone, you go and you pick them up, you bring them to the masjid to help kick off what shaitan may have gotten a hold over them. It's never too late. You haven't prayed now, you don't gotta make them up. Repent and start establishing the prayer today. 5 times in your day. قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ رَأْسُ الْأَمْرِ الْإِسْلَامِ. The matter that concerns every one of us is one thing. It is al-Islam. عُمُودُهُ الصَّلَاةِ. The pillar for our Islam is the prayer. It is the salah. So if you have a tent with just a rod in the middle, what happens when you pull that rod? A baby will know the tent's going to fall. This is what you do when you cut off the prayer. You collapse your whole life, even though you may still be living. So my brothers and sisters in Islam, be reminded of this. Towards the end of the life of the Prophet ﷺ, what did he say? He wasn't saying, go make hajj. He wasn't saying, go and do this. He was saying, as-salah, as-salah wa ma malakat aymanakum. As-salah, as-salah wa ma malakat aymanakum. The prayer, that which your right hands possess. The prayer, that's what your right hands possess. Why? This is what they needed for success. And the salah that tanha min fahshai wal munkar, it is the salah that will help you avoid evil sins and misdeeds and immorality. I leave you with 2 different set of ayat as a reminder for us. A situation we do not want to be in. يوم القيامة. قال الله عز وجل يوم يكشف عن ساق ويدعون إلى السجود فلا يستطيعون. The day of resurrection where the shin of Allah عز وجل will be made bare and they will be invited to make sajda to their Lord, to the one who created them and blessed them in this life with blessing and favor upon blessing and favor. But they will not be able to do so, the disbelievers. خَاشِعَةً أَبْصَارُهُمْ تَرْهَقُهُمْ ذِلَّةً وَقَدْ كَانُوا يُدْعَوْنَ إِلَى السُّجُودِ وَهُمْ سَالِمُونَ. Their eyes will be humbled. They will be covered in humiliation. Humiliated beyond belief. And they used to be invited to make sajda when they were in a state of peace, when they were sound in this life. Called to make sajda. Ain't nobody going to come and shoot you or kill you or anything like that. You can make sajda in your own home. You can make sajda in the masajid, which is where the men should be praying their prayers. Imagine that day you think you're going to Allah as a believer, and yet you will try to make sajda and you won't be able to bend to make sajda to your Lord because you didn't do so in this life when you were able to. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ رَهِينَةً. Every soul for what it has earned, it will be retained. إِلَّا أَصْحَابَ الْيَمِينَ. Except for the companions of the right. فِي جَنَّاتٍ يَتَسَأَلُونَ. They will be in gardens in paradise questioning each other. عَنِ الْمُجْرِمِينَ. About the criminals. About the people who are now in the hellfire. About the evil people. عَنِ الْمُجْرِمِينَ. مَا سَلَكَكُمْ فِي سَقَرَ. What caused them to enter سَقَرَ. What caused them to enter that painful, torturing torment of the hellfire. قَالُوا لَمْ نَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُصَلِّينَ. They said, we were not of those who established the prayer. وَلَمْ نَكُمْ نُطْعِمُ الْمِسْكِينَ. And we were not of those who used to feed the poor. وَكُنَّا نَخُوضُ مَعَ الْخَائِدِينَ. And we used to enter into vain discourse and talk with those who engaged in it. وَكُنَّا نُكَذِّبُ بِيَوْمِ الدِّينَ. And we used to deny the day of resurrection. Deny, deny. Not that we would die. They would deny the resurrection, coming back to life to be questioned by Allah. حتى أتانا اليقين, until the certainty became clear to us and it came to us, this is death. Then they knew and they couldn't go back. But look at what they did. What entered them في سقر, what entered them into that painful, tormentful fire. لم نكن من المصلين. They were those who did not establish the prayers. That will be the first things they tell the people of Jannah when they said, what made you go there? Do not put yourself in this state 5 times a day. If you pray them well, give it 45 minutes out of your 24-hour day. That's not even an hour for Allah. So that you could be of a successful in this life and the next. May Allah make us of those who establish the prayer, make wudu properly, sujood properly, ruku' properly, recite properly, have khushu, have taqwa, and we stand to Allah with obedience. Allahumma khfir lil muslimin wal muslimat wal mu'minin wal mu'minat al ahya' minhum wal amwat innaka antas sami'un qareeb mujib da'wat. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. اللهم اجعلنا من المصلين والساجدين والراكعين يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين وانصرنا على اعدائك واعداء الدين. اللهم انصر اخواننا واخواتنا في فلسطين وفي كل مكان. اللهم نفس قلوبهم وسهل امورهم وثبت اقدامهم يا ارحم الراحمين. سبحان ربك رب العزه عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين.